company provided me a list of recommendations for a successful season. Private advice regarding the top 10 ways in which to entrap a man. I'm telling you, Pen, the season has barely begun and already I feel touched in the head. Another quill? You do get through them at an extraordinary rate.
I have been busy with my correspondence.
To the new heir, is he here yet?
No.
Oh.
I only mean Colin has been keeping me informed of his adventures in Greece.
In fairness, I've stopped reading his letters. He rambles, does he not?
Well, he's certainly no Lady Whistledown.
No. And then again, Colin has in fact been somewhere, unlike her.
I thought you revered Whistledown. Did her arrival not save you from your presentation to the Queen?
I was delighted by the diversion, to be sure, but I sat with her paper all morning, and in truth, all she does is repeat what she hears.
Someone must report the gossip, and does she not have a way with words?
Yes, but what is she saying with those words? Truly, I did not mind Whistledown's silence the last 10 months, as it finally gave me some time to read a few articles of substance. My own sex, I hope, will excuse me if I treat them like rational creatures instead of flattering their fascinating graces. Wollstonecraft?
Rather haughty.
Imagine if Whistledown wrote like this. Instead of simply turning our eye to every newly minted debutante, perhaps then we might find our respite from the tedious sequence of tea parties and balls. I rather think that the only reason Whistledown writes about such things is because she is not an active participant in them.
Yep. Everyone has their theory, I suppose.
Mm.